Lord. I'm here to talk about the weight of the call, the weight of the anointing. God, we know how important it is to walk in your purpose for us, to walk in your calling for us. Father God, we know that the gift that you have given us is not for ourselves, but it's for others, to serve others, to give to others, to pour into others, God. Hey, God. But in transparency, Lord, sometimes the weight of the anointing, the weight of the call, the requirement. let's break down the weight. Let's break down the weight, because sometimes us church folks, we use the word weight vaguely, because we don't really want to describe what it is about the call that is pressuring on us. Because sometimes it's not just the weight of the spiritual warfare and the spiritual attacks that comes with the calling, but majority of the time it's the requirement, the things that we have to kill, the things that has to die, the things that we have to walk away from, the people we have to walk away from, because we're called, we're set apart, the habits that we have to let go of, habits that we put before the Lord subconsciously. But when you decide to take up the calling seriously, before your eyes are all the things that you have made idols, and there's going to come a time when you're going to have to decide to turn away from the idols, to turn away from the habit. The true pressure of the weight of the calling is the pressure that comes with the radical repentance, the quick repentance that's required, the forgiving that's required. Yeah. Let's not just subject the weight of the anointing or the weight of the call to only the spiritual attacks. But what about the funerals that we have to keep? The different identities that we're burying to follow the true one. So God, I ask you for the grace even now. The grace now, Lord, to carry that which you have trusted us with. Because if you didn't trust us with it, you wouldn't give it unto us, Lord. And if there wasn't an assignment for us to carry out, you wouldn't give it unto us, Lord. And you know, Lord, what we can bear. Oh God, you are the archer. We are the bow and the arrow in your hands. Pull us, Lord. Stretch us, Lord. Bend us, Lord, until your target is in sight. Do what you must, Lord, to carry out your will in us, your purpose in us, your calling in us. Oh God, we only ask you for the grace, Lord, to carry the weight. We ask you for the grace, Lord, to carry the weight. We ask you for the grace, Lord, to carry the weight. The grace, Lord, for the mantle. The grace, Lord, for the giftings. The grace, Lord, for the fruit of the Spirit. Ha. That's where a lot of the weight also comes from. People learning the fruit of the Spirit, because it's not gonna come innately. It's not that you get the gifts and then the fruits of the Spirit comes with it. You have to work and labor for the fruit of the Spirit. And you need the fruit of the Spirit to operate in the fullness of the gifting. What is a prophet without love? What is an intercessor without patience? Give us the grace, Lord. The grace for the call. The grace, Lord, for the mantle. The grace that our foot shall not be moved. The grace to not run. And the grace to stop running. Oh, Lord. Grace on your children, Lord. Maha Eka Rabasuta. The grace. Eka Labasheta Lamasa. Oh, I feel the grace of the Lord even now. Posture yourself for the grace. And I hear the Lord say, when you receive the grace, operate in the grace. You know? Don't ask for the grace and use it to get comfort. Don't use the grace as a cushion to ease the weight. The grace is for you to carry the weight. That's what I hear the Lord say. The grace don't necessarily take the weight of the anointing and the call away. Because with the call comes the affliction of Christ. And the affliction of Christ is also a part of the weight of the call. But the purpose of the grace is to carry the call. It's to move in the call. It's to operate in the call. So release the grace now, Lord, on your children.